Hi everybody, I hope you're having a great day. In this video I'm going to be covering Battle Beast. He made his very first appearance in Invincible issue number 19, November of 2004. His real name is Thok, and he stands 7 feet 6 inches tall, weighs 776 pounds, having yellow eyes and all white hair all over his body. Battle Beast was the most powerful of a leonine alien race that had vast superhuman strength, being able to beat most enemies that he came against, including many Viltrumites, who are known to be some of the most powerful beings in the Image Comics universe. He also has vast superhuman senses, which seem appropriate for feline types of beings. Battle Beast also exhibits vast superhuman speed and reflexes, durability, and stamina. He's also very proficient with hand-to-hand combat, quite often though using his very strong and sharp fangs. These being shown to be able to injure the Viltrumite leader Thrag, which is something that another powerful being named Dinosaurus was shown to be unable to do. And although he loves the savagery of hand-to-hand combat, he is very good at the use of swords, axes, and maces. Now, Battle Beast was originally the planetary guardian of his home planet, being seen as somewhat of a messiah figure for bringing peace to his world. But due to the violence and constant fighting that it took to get there, he would become addicted to fighting, and eventually left his world to seek out worthy combatants in other places. He takes combat like a sport, and funny enough, he tends to take a trophy from his defeated foes, quite often being their decapitated heads. This fact makes him remind me of the Yautja from the Predators franchise. Eventually, he'd come to serve under Machine Head, and visited Earth under the expectation that he'd get a fierce and challenging opponent. But when Titan and Invincible tried to stop Machine Head and his crew, Battle Beast easily beat Invincible and the Guardians of the Globe. Matter of fact, when he engaged with Bulletproof and Black Samson at the same time, he nearly beat them to death. It literally took him just a few seconds to then declare that the rest of the people weren't even worth fighting, and he angrily teleported away. Later on, he wound up becoming a part of the Coalition of Planets, who were looking for a way to oppose the growing threat of the Viltrumite race. He did this purely out of his desire to test himself in combat, learning that this race was extremely powerful. Later still, he's seen in captivity with Viltrumites who have been sent to execute Nolan. This is when he, Nolan, and Alan the Alien staged a breakout. And during this battle, he was able to fight a combat-seasoned adult Viltrumite and was shown to be superior. He was key in the final battle of the Viltrumite War, which ended up destroying the planet Viltrum. This is when he tasted his first quick battle with Thrag, who happens to be the leader and most powerful of all the Viltrumites. This quick engagement gained Battle Beast's attention because Thrag seemed to easily toss him aside. He keeps this in mind as he recovers from the Viltrumite War, also going on to embark on several other adventures, one of which led to him finding a new mate named Thresha. Eventually, Space Racer discovered that Thrag was located on the planet Thraxa, and this was music to Battle Beast's ears. When he goes there looking for Thrag, he's actually met by him, being asked if the Coalition had sent him to take him out, while also mocking Battle Beast for him being able to so easily beat him before. Battle Beast says that their fight wasn't over and that that was just the beginning. They then exchanged honorable formalities and began an epic several-day battle. But eventually, Thrag got the upper hand, and in Battle Beast's dying breath, he actually thanked Thrag for giving him a worthy opponent to fight and to die by. Interestingly, Thrag obviously saw him as a worthy opponent as well, because he actually had his hide removed and turned into a cape for him to wear as a trophy to commemorate this fight. Now, due to his powers and abilities and his influence on the Image Comics universe, for my 1-10 rating, I'll give Battle Beast a rating of 8, which is an unforgettable rating. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. I'll talk to you next time. Be sure to like and subscribe to The New Sage.